Hello, I am Pastor Mark Gass of Redeemer Evangelical Lutheran Church in Tomahawk, Wisconsin. In July of 1990, I believe it was July 21st of 1990, that I had the privilege to officiate at the wedding for Margaret and Fred at the home of Bill and Vera Meyer. Fred, you might remember that it was on the lawn. It was outside the house that we had that little wedding ceremony. Right behind us was this tree. It was an interesting tree, a regular tree to be sure, but yet there was one branch that was different. That was different because, if you might remember, Bill had an ability to graft branches onto a tree. And there was this tree, all the regular branches, and then there was one branch that was different, but it was still living. It was grafted into this tree. He had taken the two and they became one. I use that as an illustration for what God says in Genesis when he says, so a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. For 30 years, God took two and you were one. What a magnificent blessing. That's what God's promise was for you, and that's what God's intent was for you. That as long as you lived on this earth, you would be one in marriage. Now, I've lost track of you over the last 30 years. I don't know really what has taken place for you in Michigan. You've had obviously some great days of blessings, but you probably had some days of difficulty as well. But through it all, you've been together. God has kept you together. That's a marvelous thing. In a world today that often discards marriages, you have stayed together and you've given your children a wonderful legacy of two people working it out and staying together. That's God's intent for you, and that's God's love for you. But God's love for you is even more than just marriage. God's love for you is found specifically and more importantly in Jesus, your Savior. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. I know that Margaret was baptized into this Christian faith. I know that in her baptism, God placed faith into her heart. And that faith trusted Jesus for salvation. I know that Bill and Vera gave her a good Christian education. She believed in Jesus as Lord and Savior. As you ponder your life right now, as you remember Margaret today, it's good for you, for all of us, for all of you who are gathered there today, to remember God so loved you. Yes, 2,000 years ago when he was on the cross, Jesus, being God, saw you, each and every one of you personally. He looked down on you, he looked down on me, and he saw us, yes, in our wanderings, he saw us, yes, in our disobedience, and yet in the greatest act of love, he stayed. He stayed there. He stayed on that cross for you and for me, and he died. But then he rose again, proclaiming victory over sin, death, and the devil. That's the gift of God's love for you. Whenever we need to say goodbye to a loved one, we remember our own mortality. Life doesn't last as long as we want it to last. Our days are numbered. But the Lord reminds us to number our days aright. That is to remember him. Remember him now. As you gather at that park today, remember the gift of love from your Savior. And each and every one of you can in your heart say, God so loved me that he gave his one and only Son, that believing in him, I shall not perish, but have eternal life. This is my prayer for you. This is the prayer of our family at Redeemer Evangelical Church in Tomahawk. Even though People don't know you here, yet they've prayed for you. I know Vera has prayed for you. And we will continue to pray that God brings you blessings as you remember today, but also God gives you greater blessings as you remember him every day. God's richest blessings.